Hey YouTube, Cyclonius here. Welcome to another video. Welcome for those of you tuning in for the first time. Very often in the media, MSNBC, CBS, ABC, but in a nutshell, we see in the media that the portrayal of the flag that's behind me, the Confederate flag, is a very big racist flag, and it's a stain in our country's history that we wish to all forget. The problem is that history you cannot erase. You can manipulate it, but you cannot erase it. We cannot escape the fact that we had slavery, both in the North and the South. We cannot escape the fact that the South fought for its freedom. It fought for freedom that we have no comprehension of. Because one, we've never had to fight for our freedom that's been handed to us on a silver platter by those that did and paid for it with their lives. It's embarrassing to me in that you hear in the media people say the Confederate flag represents the KKK, the neo-Nazis, any white supremacist or any group out there that believes that anyone that's not of a Protestant or Baptist religion or race or whatever it is that they call it these days should be deported back to their homelands. Unfortunately, if I was to be deported, I would be deported back to New York City, where I was born and raised. But needless to say, all kidding aside, you know, I hear often the flag represents such and such and such and such in a negative light, such as slavery and racism. And you have to ask yourself, where are these people getting this information? It's obvious that, one, they're getting their information from the media. Two, they're getting their information from people who are a very small minority. And it's unfortunate that they take the flag that's behind me, the Confederate flag, or the rebel flag, and tarnish the very soldiers who fought for their freedom. The freedom of their country, and the freedom of their state and homes. But of course, people like Al Sharpton, and the NAACP, and Jesse Jackson, and all those groups out there, will cry racism if you show the flag that's behind me. They'll say that you're a racist, and that you're showing a flag that represents a time in our history that is negative and tarnishes the American image. Well, I'm here to say to you and to everyone out there who's listening that the flag behind me does not represent a time in our history that represents negatively upon us Americans. As a matter of fact, I think it represents a positive time in our country where For once, people stood up and said, enough is enough, we are going to fight for our freedom. We're going to fight for principles in which the foundation of our country will build upon. But of course, the liberals out there, the neoconservatives, and all those political groups out there that wish to stay in power and call the flag behind me some racist symbol, well, they do so under the guise to stay in power and not in the interest of their constituents. The people that shout these things basically have little understanding of history or tend to ignore history. They ignore the fact that 96%, or I should say, excuse me, I got my figures wrong here, 94% of the Southern population had neither the interest or support of slavery. So again, the question that boggles the mind, what was the South fighting for? And slavery was not one of them. According to Robert E. Lee, he believed that slavery was a moral evil. And according to General John B. Gordon, and I'm paraphrasing here, that perhaps 80% of the Southern armies were neither slaveholders nor had their most interest in the institution itself. So it boggles the mind. What were those 80% fighting for? And as many former Confederates say, that had been the war been about slavery, they would have laid down their arms and went back to their farms. This is a historical fact. But again, the neoliberals and the NAACP and Al Sharpton especially and Jesse Jackson forget this little facet or neglected to read that part in history. But if I may, you know, one thing I'd like to say is to those people that think that the flag represents a time in our history that represents racism, slavery, bigotry, and segregation, I want you to really rethink those words. Really rethink what you're saying that the Southern men were fighting for. Ask yourself that. What was it that the Southern men was fighting for? Forget the notion about slavery. Forget the notion that the war itself was about slavery. Forget the notion of what you're told in the media and what you read in the history books. The history books are one-sided because they all tell you the perspective from the northern side, not the southern side. The southern side is a very, very different perspective. And it's the one that, I don't want to say convinced me, but opened my eyes to what freedom really is all about. People say to me, say, Colonius, you're Hispanic. Why would you support a flag that the Ku Klux Klan and the neo-Nazis fly? Well, okay, if that's going to be your argument, well, the neo-Nazis also fly, and the KKK also fly the American flag. So are we to take the American flag and fold it and say that it's a racist flag? But again, these are the arguments that people say. So I would urge you, you know, get a Confederate flag. Fly it proudly. It represents a time in our country where, one, people fought for values under the Constitution. They fought for honor of their country and state. Most importantly, they fought for freedom. Freedom that we have little inclination of because we never had to fight for it. It's cheap for us to insult it every day, this flag as well, because we have no understanding or comprehension of what it means to lose that freedom and pay for it with our lives. The Northern and Confederate soldiers pay for it with their lives. They understand freedom. We do not. Now, I know I'll be labeled as some racist or some guy with a lisp or some guy that doesn't understand what he's talking about, but these things have no meaning to me because, one, to call me a racist, well, you really, really, really have to understand who I am and who I associate with and choose to associate with. And for anyone to call someone who displays the flag a racist and a bigot and a segregationist, well, they do so under the guise that they're ignorant. And people who shout these words, that you're racist and stupid or that you're a redneck or whatever the words that they use these days, well, they can go screw themselves. Because it's perfectly okay to honor your ancestors and honor the very principles in which they fought for. But of course, as usual, someone out there will interpret this video as something else. And that's a shame. Because freedom, at least according to them, is cheap. Thank you.